Can you convert a normal USB webcam into a studio camera with an HDMI output? Well, yes, with the OBSBOT UVC to HDMI adapter, you can. And in this video, I'm going to actually explain how this works and when this option actually makes sense. Let's go. So this small, unassuming black box here probably does the opposite of what you're used to seeing with an HDMI capture card. So for example, the Sony that I'm using now is outputting HDMI, and I'm using a cam link device like this one in order to convert my mirrorless camera into a USB source so it looks like basically a webcam to my computer. And in contrast, the OBSBOT UVC to HDMI adapter, on the other hand, takes your USB webcam and turns that into HDMI signal. So why don't I start by showing it work with a standard UVC webcam, and then I'll add something a little bit better. All right, so this is the MOKOSE UCM40, kind of a normal UVC camera. I wanted to try this out because it had all the different UVC controls lit up, because that's a per manufacturer thing. But you can see the image, at least to my eye, it looks a little bit on the pinker side than it normally does out of the box. And one thing that I was kind of upset to find as I was using this was that you can get to some of the main camera controls, the UVC camera, as it's coming through HDMI, but that's going to depend on what it sees from your capture card, not this device. So that means that in my case, the Camlink 4K capture card that I've got this routing through effectively back into my computer gives me very little settings that I can actually tweak on the camera. So because you don't have any of those settings, that's one downside to this, where you don't have those additional things to kind of modify the image of the camera. So in your video chain, what you're going to need to do is actually modify the picture in the device that eventually accepts the HDMI, kind of like I did with OBS here. But, you know, I can only get it so good, so I had to do a couple of things to tweak it. In terms of like desaturate a little bit and try to change my lighting a little bit to get the colors and everything for this particular camera to look great. So it's going to depend on the camera's firmware and kind of what it feeds the device. All right, so now I'm going to actually hook up the OBSBOT Tiny 2 to the UVC to HDMI adapter and see what that looks like. All right, so this is the OBSBOT Tiny 2. Massive improvement in terms of the picture quality, the color balance, all of those things, and kind of more or less similar to what my mirrorless cameras look like from the Tiny 2 4K camera. Just to show you what I've got hooked up with the remote control, so I'm using that USB-A input on the adapter itself, and the remote control has these preset keys. There are three of them. The nice thing is like, let's say if you're using it at different events, you can actually over program or reprogram them just by long pressing the key number. So right now on P2, it's a bit of a zoom in that I have. If I go to P3, it'll actually show the boxes for the Tiny 2 and the UVC to HDMI adapter. I can go back to P2 and I can manually go left and right on the gimbal, for example. If I wanted to zoom out, I can hit the minus or the plus key to zoom in and out. And for track, this is nice because it can actually track me automatically if I'm walking around my room. I'm not going to walk around my room too much here to get out of my light source, but this will manually track. And if you want to do close up, that means it'll actually focus in a bit tighter, but because I'm not doing a close up of anything on my desk, it's actually kind of zooming out in this case, but it will still track on that mode as well, as you can see. And one of the things that's kind of cool is if you do a lot of whiteboarding or writing on flip charts, those types of things, it will track your hand. If you want to, if you're writing, say you're writing something and you want to, if you do, some of the cooler things are actually if you write on a clear whiteboard with like a dry erase black marker, that always looks pretty cool, or white, or kind of a fluorescent marker, you can do that. It will actually track your hand as you write, which is pretty cool. So I'm going to go back into close-up mode, which is kind of the most zoomed out in my case, just because of how I've got it set up. If I go back into track again, and then I can go back into my different pre-program modes. This is P2 again. Again, this is the OBSBOT Tiny 2 with the remote control and the USB-A dongle that the remote control comes with, plugged in to the UVC to HDMI adapter. All right, so as you saw, it actually converted our webcam into a normal HDMI feed, and that's kind of where the operating system nerd in me starts to perk up a little bit, because what it had to do was actually run the camera feed in. The camera was expecting UVC controls, drivers. It was expecting something like a Windows machine, macOS, or Linux, those kind of things to operate the camera. Then in turn, I actually had the dongle plugged in to actually operate a remote control. So it was another USB device in that case that it had to know about. So that means that basically this device has more or less an operating system built into it that works with USB peripherals, in this case a web camera, and can then convert that out with like a little video processor into an HDMI device, which probably explains why this device is about $170, whereas you can get capture cards for as low as $20 or so on Amazon. So why would you need a device like this? So I see it being really valuable in a couple of ways. First, USB webcams and capture cards, they consume a lot of bandwidth over your USB ports. I, for example, start to have issues with two 4K 30 feeds coming into my Thunderbolt 4 USB ports. And that's because that bus is also sending out display signal to my two external monitors. I have an Elgato Stream Deck, I've got a Wave XLR device, and if I had something like 4 or 5 cameras, it wouldn't be possible to do this. So taking everything in means that you'd need more USB routes and buses effectively than my max spec Surface Laptop Studio has. Maybe you have a device with a lot of different USB buses, but for a lot of cases, it's going to saturate your USB channels on your machine. So in these cases, what you'd often opt to do is use something like an ATEM or a Black Magic device, which has several video inputs, either using HDMI or SDI. Then that can output either in USB-C, like a webcam again as an output device, or into HDMI for say other recorders, or direct output feeds to monitors or other equipment. And all of those different HDMI switching devices tend to prefer that each camera comes in and it uses either HDMI or SDI feeds, and that's when you'd use this device normally. Another option then would be for one of those displays that you might see at stores or theme parks, where maybe there's a camera that's constantly feeding a monitor in real time, and maybe using a little bit of AI and cropping out of the subject in the frame to replace the background behind them so it looks like they're at that store or that theme park. And that then leads me into why you would actually use this, because you could use something like a camcorder or maybe a CCTV type camera like this MOKOSE, but one that actually supports HDMI out. And those are fairly inexpensive devices to buy and to use. But the more compelling use case, I think, especially with the new crop of PTZ or pan tilt zoom cameras, is to use something like this, which is the OBSBOT Tiny 2 or the 4K or an Insta360 Link, those types of things. This one though has an advantage in the sense that it can actually be used. It's got a nice color balance right out of the box, and it has a remote control that you can use on that extra USB-A port with the USB-A dongle, so you can actually remotely control the camera and have different preset positions for the camera. So it's perfect for something like filming a church, doing a broadcast online, or maybe a basketball game like I mentioned before. And in terms of specs, it supports up to 4K resolution at 30 frames per second, and 1080p resolution at 60 frames per second output resolution. It also supports the UVC protocols 1.1 and 1.5, which means it's compatible with most webcams, and it supports 720p and 1080p on the input resolution side, and up to 60 frames per second with either of those resolutions, and 4K at 30 frames per second. It's also plug and play, so you don't need to install any drivers, because you actually couldn't in this case. So it's super easy to use. And as you saw in the first example, the OBSBOT UVC to HDMI adapter is not only compatible with OBSBOT webcams, like the Tiny 2 that I tested second, you could use things like the Tiny 4K and Meet webcams from OBSBOT as well, but also work with any other UVC webcam from all the different brands out there that support UVC. And I also ran it for several hours on end just to make sure it didn't overheat, and it doesn't, although I can say that the cameras can get pretty hot themselves. All right, so finally, would I recommend this device? Yes, for certain use cases, totally. So imagine being someone who's filming, broadcasting a church event, a live sporting event, an amateur sports type event, swimming, basketball, those types of things. You could have one camera and preset it into the three different positions, like at a basketball court, for example, with the remote and the presets. And then as a solo operator, you could announce and run the cameras pretty easily between the different parts of the field or the court or the swimming pool, and you'd be able to see all of what you need to see. Plus, as it's moving, it would actually capture during the motion itself. You could go from position one to position three as well. All of these things would be super easy to set up, and you know, you can actually program it from the remote control like I showed. You can zoom and you can use the gimbal controls in addition to that if you wanted to zoom into something or somebody. So all these things give it a lot of flexibility even as a solo operator. So I wish I'd actually had this option when I was bringing my kids to their sporting and swimming and, you know, different basketball type events as they were growing up, because then I could broadcast this out for the rest of my friends and family over the many broadcasting and podcasting services that exist today. So that's the OBSBOT UVC to HDMI adapter. Again, a great device for the right use case to be able to convert any UVC webcam to an HDMI camera. So if you like this video and you made it this far, you probably do, be sure to give me a like, otherwise subscribe to my channel. And as always, thank you for watching.